Hi everyone, welcome to Design Hat Podcast. Today we have Arpit with us. This podcast is very, very special. A lot of time we bring people who have great experience, who have less experiences, but all of that combined comes to a part where experience and the journey that they have gone through is so interesting that you want to hear through it. So today we have Arpit. He is a product designer at Flipkart. And over to you, Arpit. I just want to start this podcast with a little introduction about you, and try to kind of indicate, like, why did you choose design? Like, how did it all started?
Hello, Abhay, and hello everyone. So it's Arpit here. I'm currently working in Flipkart as a product designer, and previously I also worked in one startup in Bengaluru. So yes, a brief introduction about myself. I graduated from IIT Guwahati in 2019, and I wasn't studying design there. I was studying chemistry there, and after that I started doing design in my final year, almost when just before the placements. So talking about why I chose design, so I think I didn't choose design. Neither did design choose me, but it just happened coincidentally, and it happened in a smooth manner. So everything happened. There was some sequence of events. That's why it happened. So basically, I was into photography, videography in college, and I was doing a lot of commercial photography work as well. I did some studio shoots as well. I used to work in studios. So I was almost planned for the journey after the college that I'll either open up my own studio, or I'll join another studio in Bengaluru or any other city. But after like almost around final year, like all of my friends were preparing about coding interviews or design. So just to give you a bit reference, in IIT Guwahati, there's a branch, there's a proper department of design, and that is very important, if I say, in my journey, because if it wouldn't have been there in IIT Guwahati, I wouldn't be having any of my friends from that department, and then I wouldn't be able to know ki, okay, there's something called the UI UX design or product design or something like that. So yes, that department played a lot of big role in my journey. So yes, so I was having friends from that department, and I saw that, okay, these people do different sorts of interesting projects, which are not like generic coding projects or something like that. So I was a bit excited, okay, I am being a photographer, videographer, I used to do editing and all sorts of stuff. So I thought, okay, this is something more like relevant to artistic side. So let me, why not give it a try? Though I did some 2-3 projects, just normal, like not real projects, just hypothetical projects, 2-3, which were needed for the portfolio. I entered in my portfolio and I sat for the placements. And coincidentally, I got a job in one of the startups, which was my first company. So, and I had no prior internship experience even in design. So that was just on the basis of 2 hypothetical projects, I got a job in one of the companies. And this is how everything started. Yes, that's my journey.
I think your creative side really played an important role, because without internship, it's very difficult nowadays, because internship shows kind of some kind of experience that you have gone through. But I think your creative side definitely showed the startup really interested in you.
Yes.
I really want to ask about that design factor. So a lot of times, most of the designers that I really found, or I'm assuming mm-hmm. you also found, a lot of them, they are engineer turned designers, right? So, yes. But you are from chemistry background, and I was like, this is interesting, because chemistry has no sense of relation to design, right? So mm-hmm. I was very fascinated. So how that factor, like changing, like, I don't know how that chemistry thing you chose and how that turned into design. And that's mm-hmm. the thing that I'm really interested to know. Like, can you pour a light on that journey? Like, how that chemistry factor turned into that design, and how all that steps came into process?
Okay, yeah. So again, I didn't choose chemistry. So as you know, as I think everyone knows, like we give JEE exam and then we have to fill seats, fill the colleges and branches. And hardly I know any of my friends who give who fill it in the sense ki I need this particular branch in this college. It's not like that. We just hope for the best college and one of the best branches. So it was just like similar for me also. I filled IIT Guwahati because it was in the top six IITs of India. I just filled it and I got chemistry. And coincidentally, it was a bad luck for me that chemistry was my least favorite subject out of the three: math, physics, and chemistry. And I was like very, I'm still very bad in chemistry. I was always a very bad chemistry student. And I loved physics. I really enjoyed physics. I cracked my JEE because of physics, and I was really hoping to get into physics branch. But that was lower to the chemistry branch, and because of my rank, I got chemistry. So this is how I got into chemistry. But when after getting into the college, like from the starting only, like I had a clear sense ki, okay, in the chemistry field, the research opportunities are like this, job opportunities are like this. So they didn't really attract me from the starting only. And that's why from the beginning, I decided that, okay, either I have to change my branch somehow to another branch, which is like really difficult. I was very optimistic about it, but obviously I didn't make it. And second option was that, okay, I'll do something else, like a lot of students do in from IITs or any other engineering college, that apart from their core branch, they either do software engineering or something else. So I was also like very skeptical about software job, that whether I like it or not. That's why I started photography, videography, different other things. And that was working good. So I was thinking, okay, I already have a backup plan. Now I don't need to go back to anything, to chemistry or something. But yes, the steps, if you are asking about the steps, milestones which happened from my chemistry to design journey, that's this creative thing, photography, videography, which happened. And the next thing was that I got some development in terms of speaking ability, in terms of understanding art, in terms of actually if you say aptitude, abilities, and all that got developed. I don't know, like I think it helped in cracking my college interview placement. So yes, it helped, because I remember when there was a product manager who was taking my interview, and he was not asking design specific questions. He was asking in general some riddles and some things, and he was giving me scenarios that, okay, I showed him a project that I have built this app. I built a generic EV motor, EV vehicle monitoring app. And he told me that, okay, you have built this app. Okay, very fine. Now try to sell it to me. Now you have 2 minutes. 2 minutes. In these 2 minutes, you have to point out all the outstanding features you have built in the design, and you try to sell it to me. I don't want to see what is in your design or what is. And I managed to do that in those 2 minutes, because I was not afraid of anything. I had nothing to lose. So it was one of the only interviews I got, because my CPI was very low and I had nothing to lose. I was like, okay, I have this interview. I'll do anything to get through it. And I was just speaking things, whatever was coming into my mind. And that's how it happened.
That is interesting, because a lot of time for me as well, and I think a lot of people I have talked to, they say everything first is unplanned. What I have got from your point, like chemistry, you didn't choose design, you didn't choose, it came through the life, right? And then for this one as well, you always had this in mind that you have nothing to lose, so you gave it whatever you wanted from your heart, or from your, like, from scratch. You didn't try to fake it, you didn't try to do something extraordinary, you just did what you are. So I think these things are very important, as in terms of getting things done. Going forward, like, you worked at I think Corpen, right? So how,
Cropping,
Cropen, okay, so how did that came, like, did you apply it off campus, on campus, how did that came? And I know that you have worked at a lot of positions over there, so how did you grab that, or like put over the ladder?
Yeah, so Cropping was my first company, which I got from college placement only. That was the startup. And It's a pretty small startup, not very small, but yeah, 100-150 people odd startup, and it's there in Bengaluru only. It's a agri tech startup, so it's a very unique and quite different domain, like agriculture tech, which is not very common in terms of startups in Bengaluru or any other city. So when I was joining, I didn't know anything about agri tech or anything. I was just happy that I got a design in. That I got a job in design profile in some startup. I was fine. And I was thinking, okay, let's see. People are telling that agri-tech is might be very boring, mm-hmm. or something not very exciting like e-commerce or something like Dunzo or Zomato food delivery. But yes, I was happy that I have a job. So I went there, and it was a very small design team. It's not a B2C company, it's a B2B company. So we were working, it's a proper enterprise based company with a lot of different software products, which, and the clients are from all over the world, not just from India. So it had a very small design team of just four people, only four people, and I was the fourth member. And and in terms of number of products which that company has is, I think, six different products, and the number of designers are four. So each designer kind of has one product completely owned by himself. I'll work completely on this product, whatever comes in terms of designing that. And that was a very good thing for me. Like, initially, I was very scared because I had zero experience, not even an internship experience. And I went there, and due to the ownership and due to the task given from day zero only, I was seeing my friends who were in bigger companies. They were getting proper 2 months training or 3 months training or something like that. And I was there on day zero. And day zero only, I got some 2-3 tasks that, okay, you have to do this in next 1 week. And I was like, I remember I was on a call with my friend who was a proper designer. And I was consulting him that, bro, I have got this task on my day, first day only. Tell me how to do this. And that's how I was doing it. Like, I was just learning whatever was coming on my way. And I was very afraid. So I was overdoing it, kind of over-delivering all the things. I was I was working at the office also, and I was working after the office also, like after coming at my flat. And a lot of hard work was being put at that time. Like, initial 6 months were very hard. Each day, it was very different. So first 6 months, every day I was scared that I'll get fired. My morning used to start with this feeling that today I have to just survive somehow, that I don't get fired today. Because I was also the design team was a part of the product team, and the product team was supervised by the CPO of the company. And he was my manager, like he was my direct manager, and I was reporting to him. It was and he was a very experienced guy, like I think 30 years of experience in the industry, and he was like very big career and everything. He was like a father figure for everyone in the company, and this guy was managing me. So it was very different. He was also very like disciplined guy, and he wanted things on time. He wanted things on like perfectly and everything. And so I'll tell you one incident that on my first day, me and my two of my other friends also joined the same company, Cropin, and they were on different positions. They were software development engineers. But this particular incident on my day one, so me along with my two other friends who were in SD positions, so I was the only designer. We were in the CPO's office, and he was telling. So he was actually just talking to each one of us. And for my other two friends, he told like, okay, all the best, you will do good and everything. When it came down to me, he said, okay, you don't have any design experience. You don't even have any design degree. Oh, how are you hired? So basically he was not in the company when I was hired 6 months back in college. So he joined after that. So he was not aware like who am I, why am I hired, and everything. He was so in front of me. He was saying that you don't even have any internship experience. You don't even have any design degree and everything. Oh, I don't know. So he was like, I don't know, man. Like, I don't know either. So his exact words were that either you will do very good in design, or you'll get like you won't do anything. Like he said that okay, you won't do anything in between. Either you'll just completely rock it or won't do anything. And I was very scared. I was like, oh shit, I'm gone. This is not going anywhere. I'll be fired in 1 or 2 months. So after that, those were some words which were always there in my mind that, okay, I have to prove myself. And because the other three members in my design team all were masters in design. And I was the only bachelor with no design. So there was a huge difference in the education of my team members also. So each day I was like, I have to prove myself. So I think that helped because I was working, I was overworking every day. I was working at night also and day also. And so yes, it helped me in a lot of ways. So this was my Crop-In journey. And you also asked about different profiles. So yes, talking about that, so in startups, the profile which was given to me from college, that was UI designer. So I was like, okay, anyways, I don't have any formal education, so UX is not very good of mine. I was like, okay, I'll start with UI and slowly, gradually improve. But when I started doing the work in Crop-In, I realized that all of the work was given to me. Because I had the ownership of one whole product. So whatever was coming in that product, I was given the works. So I was like, okay, like let's learn from the day one only. So I was learning it, but after some months, I realized that anyways, if I'm doing all the work, I'm doing UX also, I'm doing visual work also, I'm doing even I was working a bit on the product side also. So why not to just get my title changed? Because if in the future I'll apply for Switch company, then they will ask, okay, what was your profile and everything. And this is in my current offer letter, so it won't be good. And that's why I asked them to change after, I think, 9 months or something. So I got it changed. And I got it changed to product designer because that means more that I was involved in all the work, which was happening from the day one. So actually, just telling about that, the profile change or the title change was just a formality. From the day one only, I was doing all the work for a particular product. So that was nothing like I got promoted in between or something like that. It was happening from the day one.
I think in a startup, it usually doesn't, nowadays it doesn't go with the title. You will get some title, but you will work everywhere. In a startup,
yes,
it goes
true.
Like this one. Yeah, but you have worked. The next question is just about that. You have worked at now you just said started with Flipkart. So, how is the difference in like a startup and this big company, and how that transition happened? Like how this opportunity also happened.
So telling a bit about Flipkart. So before I'll tell about in Crop-In. So in Crop-In, the project which I was doing or whatever. Like bigger projects which I was doing. So those were on the verge of getting completed by my completion of 1 year. So I was thinking that, I was also thinking about a domain change because I was thinking, let's try another domain. It's the start of my career. So actually, my ideology was the people who have a proper formal education of something, they sometimes don't need to experiment a lot in their initial days.
Yeah.
They don't need to because they already have a super solid background and super solid foundations of things. They know where they want to be. They know what is going to come in the future years. But for me, I had no formal education in design. So for me, that was the college. For me, that was the formal education, what I was getting in the initial 1 or 2 years. And that's why I was thinking not to stick at one place in the initial years. Let's change it after 1 year or something like that. And that's why I wanted to change the domain as well as the company. Around like after the completion of 1 year, I started looking. And for initially, I was very scared because again, I had no formal education. I had no big company badge. And I was very skeptical whether a company would accept this or not. And also because I was changing in such a short time, like just after 1 year, I was changing. And I wanted to go in a bigger organization, like not very big, but in a slightly bigger organization because I wanted to get a solid mentorship from other design team members, which was not there in the Crop-In because it was a startup. Everyone was super busy. everyone minded their own business. So not enough mentorship was there. So that's why I wanted to go in a slightly bigger organization. But when I started applying, I realized that it's very difficult because bigger organizations need proper formal education at a lot of times, and also a decent level of experience, at least 2 years. So I started giving interview assignments. After one or two interviews, I think I was confident. I was more confident. I was able to crack the assignments because generally assignment is given and the deadline is given of 2 days or 3 days at max. And I was more confident that, okay, whatever assignment you'll give to me, I will be able to complete it in 2 days. So that's how I applied in 2-3 different companies. After that, I joined Flipkart. So in Flipkart, I think I was a bit lucky because I didn't know in Flipkart, there's an enterprise design team as well. I didn't know about this. I thought it's a e-commerce B2C company. So my experience is in enterprise side companies, B2B company design team. Mm. So they won't take me, but I was not aware of that. But I saw a design person's post on LinkedIn from Flipkart that he is hiring people with enterprise design experience for his enterprise design team in Flipkart. So I asked him for referral and he gave me the referral and I started giving the interview, and that's how I got into Flipkart. And so that person is my manager currently only in my team. So, and I got to know that this team, enterprise design team in Flipkart, is a very young team. Just 2 years back it was formed specifically for the enterprise side of products in Flipkart. And so I was lucky. I didn't even know about it, that it exists. And somehow I was scrolling LinkedIn one day and I got to know about this opportunity. Earlier, before that, I cracked one or two other interviews as well. So one of the company was in B2C only also. So I was also able to crack B2C interview as well. I was not sure if I'll be able to crack, but yes, it's happened. And that's why I think You got to start giving the interviews if you want to switch, because your first one or two interviews will be bad. you won't be able to speak anything. You won't have anything to say. But after that, you'll learn. Okay, you learn a lot. What to speak, what not to speak, how to do the assignments on time. That's a very big thing. And yes, that's how I learned. And that's how Flipkart happened.
Perfect. So what have you seen in the experience? Like, you know, ki mentorship is a good change from startup to like a Flipkart based company. So how, any other change that you have felt from a startup to this product based type companies?
Yes, the change is basically in the functioning of the team. Not the type of work. Type of work is almost same everywhere. Mm-hmm. Because everyone is building digital products. Everyone is building them fast. Mm-hmm. Everyone is having same sort of ideology or everything. Everyone is almost following agile and everything. Mm-hmm. So the type of work is almost same everywhere. The only difference comes in the functioning of the team, how the team works. And that's how, that was the difference. Like in Flipkart, the total number of designers is almost 100 in Flipkart, and the enterprise design team, which I'm a part of, that is 7 to 8 members. So I'm a part of that team. And So how the team functions. So here the teams are like divided, 6-7 members each team has, and these are divided into different. That you will work on this product, you will work on this product, you will work on this product, and even in spite of being such a big team and 100 people, and there is a lot of collaboration. Like the collaboration is of very good level. And I can actually talk to anyone in the design team, even if he's not in my specific team. I can talk to anyone in the design team, even if he's the head of design. Like if I want to just schedule a meeting with the head of design also, like tomorrow, day after tomorrow, I can do that. Even if I'm directly not managed by him, I have my manager, then comes my head of design or something. So the amount of collaboration which happens is very good. And I get to see a lot of like excellent designers in the team, because some people are here in Flipkart design from past 7 years, past 8 years, or past 10 years. So they are here from that time when Flipkart was being built from scratch. So I get to learn from these people. And the good thing is that, for example, if I talk about a particular project, so whenever some big design project someone creates, he basically schedules a review meeting, which is there for all the 100 design people. And he talks about what he did, how he did, and any feedback which we want to give. So we get to know about other teams' projects also. For example, I get to know about what is happening on Flipkart's app in cart design, or anything like icon design or anything. I get to know about it. I get to give feedback about it. And this is the level of collaboration which is happening. So it's the difference in team, how the team functions rather than the type of work.
Okay, understood. I think obviously the workload would be less than the startup, because startup is very busy.
Yeah, that is correct.
And I think here a lot of designers are there. So you might, even if in a team there are 7 members, you are working on a single product. Instead of a single product from startup, you are working on some specific features as well sometimes. So I think that also happens. Yeah. So I think one of the next questions that I really want to ask, this is something beyond design. I don't know if you can reference it to, but you mentioned in your bio in LinkedIn that your life mantra is, it's not who you are underneath, it's what you do that defines you. So how did that came, and does that have any reference in your through your journey in design?
Yes. So actually, this is a famous quote from this series, the Dark Knight movie trilogy. And so, yes, actually, it's a very common saying also, not just it's a quote, but it's a very common saying also. It means basically that it doesn't matter who you are inside and what are your thoughts or what you think about something. It doesn't matter who is going to see that, who is going to get to know what are you thinking, what are your thoughts, how are your abilities, what is your knowledge level. If you're not doing anything, if your actions are different, no one would be able to know who are you. Yeah. So it doesn't matter who are you inside. It's what your actions, that is who you are. So talking about like in the design journey, for example, initially when I was in the startup in Cropin, and I was doing a lot of work and something like that. So I initiated things. At that time, I needed growth. I needed things from which I can become a better designer. And because it was a startup, people were just people were more focused upon getting things done, sprint planning and everything, just getting things out. Not a lot of thoughts were given upon the process, like how we should improve our process and all. But I initiated things. Being a part of that, I was the youngest member in the team. I was the youngest member in the whole product team. Like whole 10, 12 product team, I was the youngest member. I think I was the only undergraduate in the whole product team. So this is how it was happening. And in spite of that, I was initiating things. For example, in my, first of all, why I was initiating things, because again, that is coming from this mantra only, that if I'm thinking a lot of things in my brain that, okay, we can improve this and we can do that, how this we can do, but who is going to understand what is going in my mind? No one is getting to know. My CPO won't know. My team members won't know. My manager won't know. Yes. So I initiated things. There was no collaboration happening when I joined between the design team members. I initiated some design Wednesdays or something like that. I initiated that things that I told my CPO that we need to do this. We need to get 1 hour out of our schedules on one day, so that we talk about design in general, what is happening in the real world in design, what other people are doing, what we can do better as a team, something like that. This was one initiative. Second initiative was that one of the product was being redesigned. Okay, and everything was being redesigned, and I took the responsibility just as a side project that I will redesign this as my own, and I will point out some of the things which can be better, rather than just telling them that, okay, this can be better, this can be better. I thought that let me do this. I did it for like 3 to 4 weeks. after the office hours, during the office hours, whenever I used to get time, after completing it, after gathering feedback, I showed them that, okay, this is what I was working upon in the past 3-4 weeks. I have redesigned this app and I think there are some better things. Let's go through them one by one by one. And for example, if I did 10 things, 3 got accepted and 7 got rejected, but that's fine. At least now everyone knows that, okay, he had some inputs and 3 of them were good. And this is what someone will remember after 6 months or in the long run, that this was a person who used to initiate things, who used to do new things. So yes, this is how it's all related.
This is good because even if we have whatever in our mind or let's just say knowledge or anything, no one would care until unless you show them.
Yeah.
And I think this can more be related to one more quote, like actions speak louder than words. So
correct.
So until then you show them, it won't be, you can say anything, but you have to show them what you are really capable of.
So there are 3 things that if whatever you are thinking inside, then it comes whatever you are saying and then whatever you are doing. So you have to go to the third step.
Yes.
Until unless you are going to the third step, first two steps doesn't matter.
Exactly. People won't know now what you are capable of. That's the main thing.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's one thing. I think we are up to the last question. It's very, very important because I usually take this for the audience itself. So for your, from your whole journey, whatever you have gone through, from a startup to a product-based company, from chemistry to design, whatever you have gone through, I want to know what are the 2 tips, like 2 cents of advice that you can give to the people out there who are getting started in their design journey or who are kind of stuck where they want to go, something like that.
Yeah. So first tip, first important thing will be that try to start your career from a startup. Doesn't matter in what domain, doesn't matter. Try to be in a like quick, high growth startup, something like that. Try to find some company like that and start from there, because you will get like 10 type of work in 1 year. And in while doing those 10 type of different works, you will understand what is your specialty after 1 year. You will understand that, okay, I like doing these 5 works. I don't like these 5 works. And that will be the lesson of that, okay, you like doing these 5 top work. You don't like these 5 work. Let me become more specialist in these 5 of works. And let me try to improve these other 5 different 5 types of work in which I am not good currently. So if someone has to start, try starting from a startup, because if you, for example, if someone starts from a bigger company, like in a big company where you're only getting a specific type of work all the time, and also you are confined to one product or maybe one module also, you're confined a lot of times. So in that case, you won't be able to know what you are missing out on. You will not able to understand because you don't have any prior things to look upon. Okay, this is also, this might also be there. In a startup when I was working, so I was I remember there was one help center which was to be designed, and that was totally given to me as a, like, I was the product manager of that help center. I was also creating PRD for that. I was also creating requirements for that. I was also talking to tech team of that. Like it was given to me whole as an ownership. Because why? Because there were not enough product managers in the company and some bandwidth had to be given to someone. My CPO found that, okay, I can do it because I had some extra bandwidth. So he gave it to me and I was doing that also. Now let's imagine in a bigger company, will you ever get a chance to work as a product manager if you are a designer? The chances are very less. And that's why I think, so after that experience, I realized that, okay, I can also try product manager in the long run, like after maybe 3 years or 4 years. So this is how it goes. So that was the first thing. Second thing would be that be very curious always. Like, don't confine yourself to, if you are a designer, you are only confined to whatever is happening in design. I'll only talk design, I'll only eat design, I'll only sleep design. No, that should not be the case, because this is a, I think the current startup environment in India, it's not about a specialty. It's about having to do a lot of things at the same time. And if you are just confined to one profile, no one knows that, what if in after 3 years or 4 years, the importance of design is not that much, or maybe there are so many new designers coming that you are dethroned and you are nowhere in the industry. So that's why you should always you should always do a lot of other things also. Think about product management also, how product management works in the company, in your company. Just start from your company only, where you are working. For example, when I was in Cropin, because it was a small company, again, the benefit of a small company that you can talk to all the 100 people there. So you can cover all 100 people in the company. You are friends with full company. And this can be done only in a startup. So I used to basically make friends from different teams. I knew people from tech also. I knew people from sales also. I knew people from QA also, and different teams I had friends. So it helped me a lot that, for example, this is one thing I have noticed, that even if people, so I have some of my seniors or some people I have met in past 1 or 2 years, I have seen that there are people who have like 5 years of experience or even 3 years of experience, but they don't know like how things work in a company apart from their own team. They don't know the processes. They know I have met some of the designers or software engineers also, that they don't know that after, from where the requirements come, what is the process of coming the requirement, what happens before the requirements come, and what happens after they write the code and it goes on to the QA. They don't know anything about that, how the sales happens, how the sales team collaborates, how the product team comes up with the ideas, how the user research happens, how designers work. They have no clue about that. And that, I think, is like living in a small pond while you should live in an ocean. You are in an ocean and you are trying to live in a pond, which won't work. And in the long run, I am not someone like this. I need to know like what is happening in the sales team. What is happening in the product team? How are these requirements coming? I was fully aware about tech team. I was more aware about the tech team than my friends. Like, what is happening here? Because I was like continuously talking to people all the time that, okay, what is new happening? What is the new feature coming? Okay, what new technology we are using in the company? How is the sales happening? Okay, we generated this much revenue this year. I used to get information about the numbers. How my company is doing nowadays, how my company is generating revenues, what is the funding size, who are the investors. I used to get all this information. So be curious, whatever in your company, at least in your company, try to know everything about your company, like what is happening for each of the team. So yes, these are the two things. Try to start with the startup early on in your career, and try to get to know everything about that startup while you are there in 1 year or 2 year, whatever. These are the two.
These are the good tutors, because currently I'm also kind of interning at a startup, and I get to experience a lot of different fields, which is nice, which I love, which I didn't know, which I would like. That's one thing. So I think that is something that is really great. I think we are to the end of this podcast. So thank you, Arpit, for coming in. Thank you everyone for watching this. In case anyone who wants to reach out to Arpit, his LinkedIn and other socials will be linked down below. Again, thank you so much, Arpit, for coming in and pouring out.
Thank you, Abhay. Thank you for having me. Yeah, it was great, great sharing my experience and everything. Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. See you.